2019 is the year of the Linux phone. What? Wait, again? Wasn't that back in November 2005 when Nokia released the 770 internet tablet? Okay. So, this isn't the first year of the Linux phone. But I think a history lesson is appropriate. Back in May 2005, Nokia originally announced the 770 internet tablet, which would become its first step in building one of the most amazing branches of Linux devices to date. It was an internet tablet, and we hadn't seen anything quite like this before. This sucker was run in MIMO. It was based on Debian, running a GTK stack and a proprietary interface. But despite the proprietary interface, it was one of the coolest Linux devices that you could carry around in your pocket. Then, in 2007, at CES, Nokia was one of the big players with the N800, and it was fairly successful. Just a year later, its successor came out, the N810, this time with an epic slide-out keyboard and a way faster processor running at 400 megahertz. This was actually my first mobile Linux device that I had. Moving along to 2009, the first actual Linux phone was released, the N900. While this phone was a solid device, it was targeted mostly at developers. Shooting forward to 2011, the N9 is released. The OS is a hybrid of the MAMO operating system and MeeGo, and they definitely did a lot of work on the UI. But this phone, while it was beautiful and had decent hardware, it was never going to succeed. Before this phone actually ended up shipping, Nokia had already made deals with Microsoft to start shipping hardware with Windows Phone 7. And we all know how well that ended up working out. Once abandoned by Nokia, the proprietary interface and components that were left in the operating system became a thorn in the community side. There are efforts, though, to create a similar UI. And then, March 29, 2011, YOLA was born. YOLA was a company split off from the Nokia folks, and boy, were they hellbent on creating a good Linux phone. And while I did stare at this company creating various Linux devices slowly over time, none of them really functioned well in the United States, only offering 2G speeds and somewhat subpar processors. So I just kind of sat on my hands for a long time, almost 6 years in fact. But finally, in October 2017, you could finally reflash a Sony Xperia device with Selfish OS and get a usable experience in the States. Only downside was you had to use a VPN to get to the store to buy it. Anyway, moral of the story is there are Linux options at the moment, but they do have proprietary components and they do not run the latest version of Linux. They also run on Android hardware, which means libhybris is a required component, which makes X11 more or less a joke, and you're stuck with Wayland. So while it is a good Linux device, it is not as hackable as I would like it to be. Which brings us to this year, 2019. We see two hardware platforms that are going to be created this year. One is from Pine64, which will be releasing the PinePhone late this year. And, of course, Purism, which will be releasing a completely open phone, hardware and software, early this year. Finally, with new hardware to reinvigorate the community, we might actually be seeing some interesting mobile Linux operating systems. Happy Linuxing. Bye.